Now please do me a favor. Someone please recite those 57 words for me, line by line. Come on, go for it. Sorry?
No, yeah,
sir. So you mean to say you can't remember it? No, can I? What? It proves. Just because you say no doesn't mean people will remember. Good evening, Toastmaster of the day, fellow Toastmasters and your guests. Outside of the Toastmaster arena, I am a soft-spoken person. I speak very less. If some of you could travel in time and meet some of my school and college buddies and tell them, you know, Mamta gives a speech at the Toastmasters. What? Are you joking? Mamta can speak? I'm amused. As a teenager, I was already always pursued, pushed, tormented to speak. Mamta, speak, 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 Mamta, speak. Only then will you be heard. How are people going to remember if you don't speak? Speak now, especially my family, my mom. You need to speak. Only if you speak, people will remember what you say. And like many of you, I too had a dilemma. Will I be judged if I speak more? Or I will be judged and remembered if I mean what I say, if I say something of substance? Cut. Flashback over. Scene 2. Our very own Toastmasters Club and the most exciting session, the table topics, where the presenter is only given 1 minute to spontaneously say something. So one of such meetings of Toastmasters, I too was invited, and the table topic master of the day went to the stage and asked for volunteers. Can someone raise their hand and come up? There was silence as usual. In the corner, I saw a frail teenager. She was a guest. Slowly raised her hand. She managed to muster the courage to stand out of the crowd. And well, she was invited on the stage. She was given the subject for the day. Madam guest speaker, the subject of the day is, what is the most important moment of your life? All yours. The lady was on the stage. She had got her subject. She was silent. She couldn't speak anything. The time went by, and I'm sure it must have felt like eternity to her. She was just standing on the floor. She was frozen. 10 seconds passed. Nothing happened. 20 seconds later. Now she was literally trembling. She was frozen. She couldn't speak. Time was passing by. And the crowd, the audience could feel her distress. I too was sitting in the corner. And pain. God, please give her the courage to speak. Let her say something. 30 seconds had almost gone. And suddenly what happened? She shouted, Toastmasters, the most important moment of my life is when my mom said she trusted me. Those were just three simple words. I trust you. such small 3 words had given her the courage to face a situation which was terrifying. Believe you me, simple words, some expressions, small gestures can actually give a lifelong inspiration. And this very some words can break hearts. They can spread hatred, pain, agony. They can inspire. Toastmasters, I believe, and you have proved, that doesn't matter how much more you say. What matters is what you say. So let us vow today and decide that we will speak that which actually means something to someone and spread happiness